In the C7 video, we finished with this one, looking at our graph. So again, if you need to pause it, please do so as you are looking at this. We now want to take a look at the very last problem. And it says, make a graph that shows the relationship between the number of students, x. So x is going to be our number of students. So that would be our students down here that we are looking at. The number of students that go to a football game by bus, and the number of buses, y. So y is going to be our buses that we are looking at. I'm going to try and write with my pen, buses, there we go, that are needed for each, because each bus holds a maximum of 50 students. Answer the question below to help you with your graph. So what does that point 0.01 before we think making our graph? 0.01 means in terms of students and bus. And will it be an open or closed graph in it when we think about that? And remember, x is our students. That's our students. And our y is going to be the number of buses we need. So if we are looking at this xy point of 0.01, this means we have 0 students. And one bus ordered. But if we think about this, the question is, does it make sense if we look at that? And so if no students show up, we would really want to think of having an open circle on our graph, right? And we might want to be thinking about our graph, what are we going to use if we know that it's going up by the buses can hold 50 students. So when we're looking at that, we might want to think of our buses going up and say maybe that this is one bus. This is going to be our second bus. Here will be our third bus, fourth bus, and fifth bus that we might need. If we're looking at our students, we might be thinking about, oh, what about when we have 50 students? 75, 100 students, 125, this would be 150 students. Then we'd have 175, we'd have 200 students, and 250 students. So setting up our labels. So 0 students, 1 bus. If we are thinking about that, that might, we'd have it 0 all the way up till we hit 50 students. 50 students can fit on that bus, so it's going to be a closed circle. So in this one it says, what is the last x value that'll go on bus 1 to the game? That's when x equals 50, like we were just talking about. Is that a point on our graph? Yes, the point is located at 50, comma, 1. Should it be open or closed? This one should be, if we are looking at it, it'll be a closed circle. And if we think about what they said in the video about the constraints, and it's closed since 50 people can ride on one bus. Okay. Now, look at this next question as we're going to go make our graph. It says, will the point 52 be open or closed? And we want to think about that. In this case, if we're at 50 and now we're having to get that second bus, it should be an open circle. How many more people can ride on that bus? All the way up to 100. Again, that'll take us to our second bus. So is 52 going to be open or closed? We're going to say that this is going to be open. And our reason for it being open is if there are 50 students, that is going to be only bus one, okay? But if you have more than 50 students, that's when you start your second bus. So if we have 52 students, we would have a second bus ordered. So if we have more than 50 students, you will always need 2 buses. You would need 2 buses until you get to 100. And then we would be moving to our third bus. And then to our fourth bus when we hit. and then to our fifth bus if we are looking at this. So this is still a function, it's a piecewise function. So if we're continuing that, it says, okay, if we continue graphing until 236 students fit on the bus, how many buses are we going to need? If you take a look at that, what you might be thinking is, oh, we're going to take 236 and we divide it by 50 and we should have 5 buses. How many buses was that going to get us to the game? We would need 5 for all those students. We will be having a homework quiz when we look at this tomorrow, probably on our translating and with absolute values if we haven't done that already.